So our first competitor is Deepak Kumar, who's a master's student in food science. His advisor is Dr. Danielle Belmer, and the title of his talk is Microbes, an Alternative Source of Protein. So, ladies and gentlemen, here's Deepak Kumar.
It's 3:30, a perfect time for a protein snack. Speaking about protein, in this country, we get access to so many different sources of protein. But do you know, before I complete this 3-minute presentation, about 800 people would die due to insufficient intake of protein. This staggering number of deaths is increasing every day. A large world population and depleting natural resources make it even harder for people to access protein in many countries. A solution for this problem is getting an access for more sustainable and cost-effective protein. Wait a minute. What if I told you a tiny microbe can solve this problem? Yes, you heard it right. These tiny microbes can be grown in a large quantity in a more sustainable way. They are neither seasonal nor climate dependent. Spirulina is one such microbe, a naturally occurring microalgae, which is rich in protein and essential nutrients. In comparison with beef, spirulina has about 3 times more protein and requires 50 times less water and 200 times less land to produce the same amount of protein. This sustainably grown protein can even use wastewater as a source of nutrient. Well, despite all these benefits, why are we not seeing this protein in the market? The reason is this spirulina protein has a really bitter taste which limits its application in food products. Now that's where this research comes in. In this research, we have used an innovative encapsulation technology to mask the bitterness of spirulina protein using a polysaccharide sodium alginate, which when reacts with calcium chloride, forms a gel network. This gel can hold the spirulina protein and also act as a barrier between your taste bud and the protein source. But does it work? Absolutely. These formulated beads do not taste bitter when compared with the actual protein source and can be incorporated into food products to enrich the protein content and also make it taste better. This sustainable and cost-effective protein can be used as an alternative to expensive animal protein. Now, I firmly believe this research will trigger future interventions to use spirulina to reduce the risk of protein malnutrition and save millions of lives. All being said, I have one last question for you all. Did you ever imagine these tiny microbes can replace your steak? Brace yourself, that day is coming. Thank you.